हेलोइट्स गुड मॉर्निंग वेलकम बैक टू अवर सोशल क्लास इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फर्स्ट लेसन व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट लेसन चिल्ड्रन आई लव माय इंडिया व्हाट इज दैट आई लव माय इंडिया एज अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट सम इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास व्हाट आर दोस या व्हाट इज द वेयर इज द लोकेशन ऑफ इंडिया नाउ इंडिया इज लोकेटेड इन द एशियन कॉन्टिनेंट You know, children. Already we have discussed. Now, India is located in the Asian continent, and it is occupying seventh place in the area-wise and second place in the population-wise. Isn't it, children? Now, coming to the next point. In the northern part of our country, here there are northern mountains. What are those called? Yes, Himalayas. The Great Himalayan Mountain ranges are located. Okay, now in the four sides, that means our four sides. What are those? East, west, north, and south. In the north, Himalayan mountains are there. In the south, Indian Ocean. On the west, Arabian Sea. And in the east, Bay of Bengal. These are the boundaries of India. What are those? In the north, eastern part, Himalayan ranges. And in the south, Indian Ocean, on the west, Arabian Sea, in the east, Bay of Bengal. Okay, now coming to the next point, what we have discussed, what are the neighboring countries of our country? Next, what is that? Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, and Sri Lanka. Bangladesh and Sri Lanka. Again, Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, and Sri Lanka. These are the neighboring countries of our country. Now, we are going to discuss today some important points about our country. Still more. Okay. Now, coming to the political divisions of India. Already we know that in the third standard we have learned our India is divided into 28 states and 9 union territories. Did you remember, children? 28 states and 9 union territories. Now, when we got independence, children? In 1947, August 15, our India became an independent country. From the Britishers, we got the independence. Now, that day onwards, we are independent. Okay? Because of many people sacrificed their lives. Who are those? Already said, no? Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, Srimati Sarojini Naidu, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. Because of these people, many people sacrificed their lives for our freedom of our country. Okay, children? Now, coming to the next point about the facts of our country. Some facts I have given here. In our country, what is the largest state, children? It's Rajasthan. What is the largest state in our country? Rajasthan. What is the smallest state? Yes, it's Goa. What is that? Goa. Goa is the smallest state. Coming to the next point. About seven sisters. Seven sisters means these seven states are located in the northeastern part of our country. This side. This side, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Meghalaya, Assam, total seven in number. These seven states are called seven sisters. These seven states are known as seven sisters. Where they are located? In the northeastern part. This is eastern part. This is the eastern part of our country. In this side, the seven sisters are located. What are the seven states? Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, and Tripura. Once again, children, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, and Tripura. Just a small thing, children. This is, we can remember easily. The states your country, you know, while you are writing. If I am asking which states are known as seven sisters, then what you will do? What is the first one? What is the second one? That's what? Here we have given small tick. What is that? A square, N cube, N D. A square means A to start it. Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. A square, two are there. Next is M letter. Starting letter M. Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, 3. Okay, next Nagaland N, Tripura, T. A square, M cube, N D. This is a small. small tip for remember to remember the seven sisters. Now coming to the next one, Telangana is referred to the state. Already before 2014, listen carefully children, before 2014 this Telangana is in our state Andhra Pradesh only. In 2014 June 2nd this Telangana state is formed, newly formed from our Andhra Pradesh. It is our Andhra Pradesh is divided into two states. What are the one is Andhra Pradesh and one is Telangana. What are the capital of Telangana children? Most of you know that, that's known as Hyderabad. Did you remember children, Hyderabad? Mostly everybody went, I think. Yeah, Hyderabad is the capital of Telangana. What is the capital of Andhra Pradesh? Yes, now it's Amaravati only. Okay, in 2014 June 2nd our Andhra Pradesh is divided into two states, that is one is Telangana and another one is Andhra Pradesh. Okay children, shall we go to next point? Ready. Now next point is about our physical divisions of India. How India is divided into physical divisions. Okay, now as a part of that, our India is divided into five physical divisions. How many? Five physical divisions. The first one is this part, Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh. These states are located in the Himalayan ranges. The Himalayan mountain ranges are located in this part. This is one of the physical division. Next coming to the Northern Plains. Northern Plains. These are Northern Plains. Many rivers are flowing through this. Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra. These important Northern rivers are originating in the Himalayas and they are flowing through this Northern Plains. That's what these Northern part of plains are very popular in our country. They are cultivating different type of crops. Okay. Now coming to the next one, desert. The western desert. It is located in the western part of our country, no? So it is called as western desert. Now coming to the next one, southern plateau. This total is a triangular area. This triangular area is divided into southern plateau. It is one of the physical division of India. Plateau means mostly rocky area. Okay, children. Next, coming to the next one, eastern side, eastern coastal plain, and the western side, western coastal plain. After this northern plain, these are also plains. Now, our Kakinada is located here. Now, we are also living in the coastal area. Which coastal area? We are living in the east side, way of Bengal side. That's what this side known as eastern coastal plains. And coming to the western part, these are called western coastal plains. Western coastal plains. The plains are divided into eastern coastal plains and western coastal plains. And also the fifth one is here Lakshadweep Islands and here Andaman and Nicobar Islands. You know children, what is an island? Already have learned in third standard. A piece of land surrounded by water on all sides is called an island. Okay children, now our India is divided into five physical divisions. What is the first one? Northern Himalayas, next Northern Plains, Western Desert, Southern Plateau and Coastal Plains, and also Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Okay children, these are five physical divisions of India. Today we have discussed about the physical divisions of India and also political divisions of India. Now shall I read the remaining states and capitals? Will you learn children? Please learn and be ready for the textbook exercises and also notes. Already 10 we have discussed in the previous class, isn't it children? 10 states and capitals. Now coming to the 11th one, Karnataka, Bengaluru, Kerala, Thiruvananthapuram, Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal, Maharashtra, Mumbai, Manipur, Imphal, Meghalaya, Shillong, Mizoram, Aizwal, Nagaland, Kohima, Odisha, Bhubaneswar, Punjab, Chandigarh, Rajasthan, Jaipur, Sikkim, Gangtok, Tamil Nadu, Chennai, Telangana, Hyderabad, Tripura, Agartala, Uttarakhand, Dehradun, Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow, West Bengal, Kolkata. Remaining states also I have written down now children. Please everybody, every day you have to memorize these all the states and capitals along with that all the union territories. What I said, 9 union territories now? What are those? Andaman and Nicobar Islands. What is the capital of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, children? That is Port Blair. Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Port Blair. Chandigarh, Chandigarh. Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Silvassa. Daman and Diu, Daman. Jammu and Kashmir, Srinagar and Jammu. Ladakh, Leh. Lakshadweep, Kavarati. National capital territory of Delhi, Delhi. Puducherry, Puducherry. These all they have given in your social textbook. Please read all these states and capitals along with the union territories also. Okay, children. Now I will explain in the map. Be ready. Already we have discussed about the borders of India and boundaries of India and also about the neighboring countries of Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, and Sri Lanka. Now, in today's class, what we have discussed, our country is divided into 28 states and 9 union territories. In 2014, this is our Andhra Pradesh, children. This is our Andhra Pradesh. Now we are living here, Kakinada. Okay. In this Andhra Pradesh is divided into two states. In 2014, June 2nd, it is divided into Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. What is the capital of Telangana? Hyderabad. What is the capital of Andhra Pradesh? Amaravati. Now coming to the next point, Seven Sisters. These are located in the northeastern part of our country. This is Kerala. This is known as northeastern part. Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Manipur, Nagaland, and Tripura. These seven states are called Seven Sisters. These seven states are called Seven Sisters. Okay, children, did you understand?